coronavirus disease 2019, or COVID-19 for short, which is caused by the SARS coronavirus 2. Still, at the time of the making of this video, is considered an epidemic and not a pandemic. So here are the latest numbers of confirmed cases. This is as of February 20th at 5:43 p.m. So we have 76,199 total cases, and the vast majority are in mainland China. As of right now, there's 15 in the U.S. They actually temporarily changed this from 29 to 15. So it actually went from 15, and then they had those 14 cases that they brought from the cruise ship. But they're considering that not U.S. because of the location where they were first found to be a confirmed case. So actually, they changed that from 29 back to 15. These are the total number of deaths, 2,247. Only 9 of these deaths have occurred outside of mainland China. Total recovered, 18,177. When you calculate the case fatality rate based on these numbers, it's going to be 2,247 divided by 76,199, which off the top of my head, I don't know what that is, but I think it's around 2, maybe slightly higher than 2%. Now, it's fair to say that these numbers are being underreported, but the ones that are being disproportionately underreported are the total number of cases. Here's why. It's easier to track a death because a death is obvious. It's easy to track deaths from coronavirus in hospitals. And if someone dies at home, it's relatively easy to make a post-mortem diagnosis at the autopsy. So the number of deaths from COVID-19 are more accurate than the total cases because it's a lot harder to make the diagnosis in someone who has little to no symptoms, because the people with little to no symptoms are less likely to seek medical attention. So when someone is infected with SARS coronavirus 2, the symptoms can range from no symptoms at all to mild disease, to moderate disease, to severe disease. And then it can be at its worst when you have respiratory failure with septic shock, multi-organ failure, and death. Some might say, yeah, but they're screening some people in some cases, which is true, but the vast majority of people who are being tested are symptomatic. Also, there's a higher potential for a false negative when someone is asymptomatic or has very mild symptoms. This is at least part of the reason why the CDC has certain criteria on who to test. And as of right now, that criteria includes people who have symptoms, who've been in close contact with someone with a confirmed case, or someone who's been in contact with someone who's recently been to China. So knowing that there's a lot of cases that are not being diagnosed, mainly because people with little to no symptoms don't seek medical care typically, that means that our case fatality rate is going to be much lower than the one I mentioned earlier in this video. Many epidemiologists think that the case fatality rate is going to be about 1%. But let's take a look at the largest COVID-19 study to date, which just came out the other day, February 17th. It looked at 72,314 cases of COVID-19. These were either confirmed or suspected cases. The study was done at the Chinese CDC and published in the Chinese Journal of Epidemiology. So looking at the numbers in this study, 44,672 out of 72,314 patients were confirmed cases of the virus, so 62%. 10,567 cases were clinically diagnosed, so that's 15%. And there were 16,186 suspected cases, that's 22%. Also, of the 72,314 patients, there were 889 cases of patients who had no symptoms. The ones that were deemed clinically diagnosed cases, those are patients who demonstrated all the symptoms of COVID-19, but have either not been able to get a PCR test or are believed to have a false negative test. In about 14% of cases, the virus caused severe disease, including pneumonia and shortness of breath. In about 5% of cases, patients were critically ill with respiratory failure, ARDS, septic shock, multi-organ failure. Of the 44,672 confirmed cases, there were 1,023 deaths, which gives us a case fatality rate based on these numbers of 2.3%. But due to some people having mild to no symptoms and not seeking medical attention, that case fatality rate would be expected to be more like 1%. In 2003, SARS had a CFR of 9.6%, which is much lower than the CFR of MERS, which was 35%. But because SARS was much more contagious, it caused almost the same amount of deaths as MERS. SARS had 774, MERS 828. The virus that's causing COVID-19 has infected at least 76,000 people so far, and despite having a lower CFR than SARS and MERS, has actually caused more deaths than those other coronaviruses combined. With the influenza virus, the CFR is 0.1%. But so far, influenza has killed 12,000 Americans this year, and on average, it's responsible for 500,000 deaths worldwide. That speaks to just how contagious the influenza virus really is. But let's get back to the coronavirus disease, COVID-19. We mentioned that it probably has a CFR of 1% or so, and that it caused 2,247 deaths. Many of those deaths have been among older people and/or those with medical conditions that make them more susceptible to being critically ill from viral infections. This large Chinese CDC study found that among patients aged 80 and above, the CFR was 14.8%, and for those with pre-existing conditions, such as those with heart disease, the CFR was 10.5%. That means for younger adults without any medical conditions, the CFR for them is less than the total CFR as a whole. So what that means is for younger adults who don't have medical conditions, their CFR is going to be less than 1%. Now let's talk about the healthcare workers in the Wuhan area. 3,000 hospital staff or other medics had been reported to have COVID-19 based in this study, and 90 of them died. So that's a CFR of 0.3% for those healthcare workers who were infected. Now, in China, the number of new cases per day is starting to level off, maybe even trend down. You can see the total daily deaths kept going up and up and up. And then February 12th, looks like it peaked here, and then it's kind of leveling off here, maybe going down. So is the total daily deaths going to trend down? Don't know yet. It's still too early to tell. Will COVID-19 become a pandemic? Also, too early to tell at this point. I think we'll have a better idea in the upcoming week or so. Oh, and one more thing that came out of this study is that COVID-19 rarely affects children. If you found this video useful, give it a like. And if you want to see more videos from me, click on subscribe. And if you want to be notified of when the next one comes out, click on the bell. I'll see you in the next one.